Welcome back to Quantum Black, Season 4, Episode 2 of the New York City arc in the Blackout Zone. When last we saw the group, they had gone through some of the streets and down into the subway tunnels to make their way from the Quantum Integrated Technologies building, moving towards the Wynn Intelligent Systems Tower. In the subways, they were able to find a safe route until they came across a group of exploded people from like the hobo network, all these dead bodies. I don't think anybody lost sanity from that because you're all very accustomed to seeing blown up people at this point. But moving forwards down the line, you came across another station, which all of the entrances and exits up to the street, the normal blockades have been opened up and demolished. And I think that is pretty much where we left off. So, we are down Sam Riley today, so he's taking a point in the back, covering your retreat. Dr. Desdemona, as you get toward, like, you're investigating the subway station, and you can see that there's been, all the blockade has been destroyed and reopened up. You can see the city above you. You get a flicker of cell coverage on your Quantum Black phone, which is one of the only ones that will have cellular coverage in here. And you get a series of text messages ding on your phone from both Green and another person.
The doc will like do that signature, try to hold the phone up in the air where he can still kind of read it, but get the best coverage and try to catch up with what's going on.
Through the discourse with Green, which for those not familiar, Ian Green is the chief supply officer for Quantum Black. So whenever you roll for requisition checks, it goes to Green or one of his team members, and they try their best to get you the requested items that you wish. So I'm gonna go ahead and open up this map here for you to take a look at. At this point, you're about two-thirds of the way from the QIT building all the way up to your target at the Wiz Tower. So the subway station is open up to the street and continues on down the tunnel.
I believe we did decide that we wanted to go through the tunnel, if I'm not mistaken. Just to keep going underground. Anybody want to try their chances above ground?
We might have to. The doc, like, reads, you know, his messages, you know, maybe even fires something back, and then looks over at the rest of the party and is like, well, I've been updated to some information that we might wish to be privy to. It turns out that one of our warehouses is nearby. We might be able to find some stuff there that will benefit us throughout this. I suggest we make a detour.
Well, if we're going to be dealing with robots and ghouls and whatever else I wasn't informed about, maybe more gear wouldn't hurt. How time sensitive is this asset saving of ours?
Well, we don't have too much longer before we have to, you know, get out of New York, but I figure, you know, it's only like maybe an hour's walk there and back to the Wiz Tower, so depending on what we run into. And knowing Green like I do, I imagine we might find some stuff that might even make our way to his tower faster.
Okay. Can I call my rat swarm back and have them do an above ground sweep? Did I already have them do an? I don't remember.
You had them go up the subway tunnels, if I remember correctly.
Okay.
It is a new game. I will have you re-roll a new ritual magic.
For sure. Okay. Yeah, let me go ahead and get that rolled.
I imagine I have, like, when, like, Green's messaging me the information and stuff, he probably sent me, like, a satellite image of where the warehouse is at and stuff, right?
He also sends you the code for the lock and the identification for where the false walls are in the building to access the hidden storage compared to the public storage.
Excellent. I'll tap the image of the satellite image so that that's all that you can see on my phone, and I will show Peter and be like, we need to get to that location.
Okay. So,
can I have my rats do a scout out, or do I need to roll again?
You'll now roll an investigation check or survival. You can have synergy with... I'd say that's actually survival, but you can have synergy with investigation if you have it.
I have a like a 7 rating of on investigation. So what's the
So just roll bonus? With +2.
+2, got it.
Okay. So with your knowledge of the area, you are aware that there's kind of two routes that you could go. So the first route is on foot through the streets. The second route is moving over a little bit and then just jumping back down into another subway tunnel.
We could take the subway still. No guarantee that there'll be an opening where the other tunnel is, has access to the road, or we could go above ground.
Well, do your rat scout thing, and I guess we'll figure out what's the best route.
Still personally say better safe under the cover of walls than risk going up and bringing all of New York on us.
The only other thing I'm worried about... Yeah, you're quite loud. The only other thing I'm worried about is if we get to the safe house and want to get to the underground to get to tower, I think that making sure that opening is good would be best. So I think sticking to the subways is our best bet.
You are such a fishbowl.
Very, very muffled. I'm going to have
to get... Better?
Oh, that's much better. I was about to give Vinny a speech impediment flaw.
I had my microphone behind my head like a dummy.
Oh, that won't make it work. Yeah.
You're not supposed to
I vote for above ground. I have a bunch of grenades, and grenades are not particularly safe when used underground.
They're also loud and will bring everything to us.
But then they'll kill everything. So it depends on how many you have.
No, all of them are loud. I have a few not loud ones.
I imagine he doesn't have enough grenades to deal with the entire population of New York.
Just the undead ones.
Which is like the big percentage, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Even a small percentage of 1.7 million in Manhattan alone. It's pretty, like, what's 1% of 1.7 million? It's a lot.
It's a lot, yeah. I would still stick with below ground and use the grenades to potentially blast out our route.
Yeah, the last time we had an explosion, it covered our escape pretty well. Rather have it cover an escape than bring everything down upon us.
So, the at Station 14 where you're at, again, there's the ramps and staircases going up to the streets are covered with blockades and debris and stuff that everybody's like boarded it off, almost tried to block it from the upper city, but it has again been blown open, so there is a pathway easily to go up if you wished.
What's if I look up before we start moving, if I look up what I can I get type time of day? afternoon. I'm not going for specifics, but, you know, just still, by sun.
It's still nighttime. It might be
okay.
1 in the morning. Maybe not even that. Maybe, like, still 11 o'clock at night.
So not nowhere near to sunrise.
No, you've got a lot of time for sun. Because it's not that far to get from the QIT building to Wiz. I mean, it's a hike to get there, and you have to gotta be careful. Mm-hmm. But it's not going to take over a day to get over there.
Okay, cool.
I want to say it was like less than 5 miles, if I remember correctly.
So then if we're just walking, I feel like walking the rails is our safest bet.
So, Peter, if you can roll a perception check for me. And you are shrinking into yourself a little bit and like using the rat's eye vision instead of your own.
Most likely, yeah.
Okay, so let me just check. Vincent's is not cosmic sensitivity. And I don't think Zach has cosmic sensitivity either. So you both just see this compatriot of yours begin to cast his spell, and all the rats kind of like swarm and move up the ramp into the city. And as they wander around the streets, there are zombies around. There's dead zombies around, smashed cars. For the most part, there's no hordes in the couple blocks around the station. There's just like the couple shamblers around.
Any active, like, loud noises going on around, or is it pretty quiet?
No, you don't hear any specifically loud noises.
Quiet noises?
Slaying zombie? I don't know.
Okay.
Yeah, but it seems like if you were to try to stealth, you could avoid it, or if you took time to eliminate a couple walkers here and there. The free dead. That's funny.
I mean, above ground isn't too... How long is the walk above ground?
If you walk on the upper area, it's 1.2 miles, the shortest route.
Hmm.
It's probably similar and to go on the subway.
I still feel like the below ground is going to be a better bet, even with it being relatively quiet.
Subway's been treating us good so far, ever since we entered the city. I mean, it has been treating them good, and if we're still around the corpses, just point to the mass of exploded corpses, but it's been treating us good.
Yeah, I was about to say, the doc looks over at the dead hobos everywhere, all over the walls. I mean, yeah, it's been treating us good.
I wasn't... Wait, wasn't I here not too long ago? Just putting that out there.
What do you mean by here?
At the place where the hobos got killed. Didn't I go through here a couple days ago?
Yeah, this is all fresh. This is like within a day. Okay. The blood's like sort
there
of
were... dead, but... What I remember, there were grenade marks and bullet marks.
Mm-hmm. They were blown up by explosives, and the whole area was like spattered with bullets.
Yep. Anyway, do we know if what killed them went back above ground, or if it is still in the sewers?
Do you want to try to search? I don't think anybody really searched in that way.
Can I roll some sort of investigation perception check just to see if
yes, you can.
That
what be would you investigation?
Prefer? Investigation. Do I get
a survival too? If you're trying to like track,
it's I have 7 in both, so it doesn't matter either.
Just roll
way.
One with a synergy +2.
Cool. I can't tell. I just
yeah. There's. There's not really any footprints on the tile steps of the subway.
If I see what Peter's doing, could I pop up onto the stairs and, similar to what the doc was saying in the chat, could I also see, like, you know, any, you know, bloody footprints or maybe shell casings if they weren't picked up or, bullet casings to follow them?
There are plenty of shell casings. So you're moving, that's kind of northeast-ish up through the tunnel, back by where the hobos were. There's shell casings all through that northern tunnel as soon as you kind of get within shooting contact from in here.
From in the entrance of the subway or inside the subway?
In the subway. So, like, if you're coming south-ish down this tunnel, the bullet casings are all, like, in this stretch.
Could I also roll an investigation to see if I could follow them to see if they go up or if they go further down?
Yeah, you can roll also investigation / survival. I don't care particular which one. Synergy if you have both.
Let's see. I do indeed, so that is a +2. And that's either or, right?
Yeah, whichever. In this scenario, I don't actually care which one you roll.
Alright, so I'll do investigation with a +2.
Did you say there were splody marks around here?
Yeah, the...
Can I look at the splody marks and figure out what caused them? Or do we know what caused them?
I
think they were hand grenades.
You can roll demolitions check to try to do that, and if you have investigations, you can synergize with it, but it'd be demolitions primary.
I have pretty good demolitions. I would like to assist. That would be a +2.
Do you want to assist or do your own roll? Would the doc just be doing the thing? Or? Okay.
I just, like, instead of both of us trying to, like, roll, like, yeah, he'll just be like, oh, yeah, these scorch marks look like blah, 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 throwing out, you know, the same type of information that, you know, just bouncing it. Okay.
So, that, to you looks like it was definitely grenades from the... There's no, like, casings necessarily for it, but... You can gather that it is probably thrown or shot from about the same distance and time as, like, the machine gun started firing. And what was your roll was a 6. Yeah, it's just like 5.56 casings.
But does it lead up or out?
They begin in the tunnel, and there's from the point that it begins, from, like, again, it's about here, moving towards the hobos. Once you get to the top here where you're at, station 14, everything from the debris looks like it was blown inwards, so maybe more grenades, but the blast was as if someone was entering the subway, breaking through the blockade.
Okay, I did not need to roll twice there, that's my bad.
So all the tracks that I see aren't going out of the subway, they're going deeper in.
The tracks that you see from the casings, if you're trying to look for footprints and stuff, back up at the station 14 by the broken blockade.
Yeah, if there were any bloody footprints, like one of whoever did this stepped into one of the dead bodies and trailed his way.
For that, roll a survival check.
Okay.
Vincent, with 8 successes for demolitions, if you're kind of looking as well, I'll give you a little bit more information that it was a grenade launcher. The grenades were shot from a device. But apart from the entry going in, you don't really see any evidence of where the perpetrator went after the deed was done. So either he or she is still in the tunnels, or it's retreated back to the surface, or found.
I know what type of grenades.
You can know that it was grenades that would be shot from a grenade launcher, a Fenris grenade launcher.
Uh oh. I know who had one of those, and so does Peter. I, out of character, know. In character, Peter knows.
P- Peter is still inclined to stick with the subways.
So Graves would come back from his searching and say, you know, all of the casings and any markings that I've found seem to be leading further into the subway. I imagine a 2 really doesn't give me much.
Hmm.
I don't see anyone going above ground. It's definitely possible they went deeper in. But they seem to be having headed through the hobos and not towards the hobos and not through. So it's possible we missed them. It's possible we'll miss them again. Still personally rather deal with some crazed survivor in the tunnels than a horde of the undead, if you ask me. Easier to take down a human than something that might get back up.
I've met a few humans that don't go down easy, though.
Right, but doesn't the human put that potentially in the subway to have a grenade launcher? Well, I mean, I guess if... Did Vinny tell us that he realized they have a grenade launcher?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, so are we sure we might want to run into someone that has a grenade launcher, potentially?
I has a grenade launcher. Gently shrugs it.
Is the answer to people, to the question of where do we want to go, people want to go above ground? There are less here. I will give you that.
Personally, I still think with the combined might of Quantum Black, I think we'll stand a easier chance against one lone man with a grenade launcher than these hobos did. Especially if he's heading away from us. If we do run into him, we could get the drop on him and take him down easier than, as I said, you know, a horde of zombies if we were to make some noise.
Beck, I think you're muted.
Doctor? What's your decision?
Yeah, I think Graves would also look towards the doc as team lead.
I don't like the idea of the underground only because if, you know, we end up getting in, like, a situation we only have one direction to run, and what if it's into a dead end? But that being said, the likelihood that, you know, we will draw ire while underground is a lot lower than while, you know, above ground, so, and definitely underground.
Okay. I guess pack up to keep going underground. I imagine I was eating snacks during this. Cheese. This was a really long break.
Cheese snacks.
Yep. Graves. Definitely some string cheese.
Graves will flip back on his night vision goggles and get ready to move.
Okay, so as you mount the steps up to the surface level, you pass by all the rubble and debris.
Surface level?
Is that not what you...
We are going on a different subway.
You still have to cross over. So if you go here...
Well, you couldn't just change tracks from underground?
Oh, I guess
Adrian doesn't know how that works. He's never been to New York.
I will divert to your knowledge if you can do that.
Absolutely can change tracks from underground. You just take a staircase to the other track.
Oh, okay. Yep. Well then.
Go up over to the other side.
Then you can
do I was that. Like, what's happening here?
The GPS says walk a walk a block over. So
I mean you can, depending on the location of the station, or you know, you just change tracks.
Okay. So
it's fictional Quantum Black New York.
It is. It's definitely going to have holes in the realism. But yeah, if you go backwards to where the cross is and you can move over, go for it. So I will have you all roll stealth if you wish. The subway tunnels does appear empty, so it's up to you if you want to bother with that. I was definitely going to have you roll that if you went to the surface.
I'm definitely just being normal here.
I'm not even going to play games. Graves has felt fine in the subways. I'm not even going to bother rolling if it's not mandatory.
Okay, so you just kind of proceed.
You do that so you won't roll a zero.
Yeah, I mean, I could spend a billion style points on it, but...
Okay. As you get to... This looks like a pretty busy intersection. There seems to be another blockade up ahead, but it's not, like, completely solidly blocked, but there's, like, stuff... Like a barrier, like a bit of a wall. And you've got your light vision goggles, Graves.
I do indeed.
You can roll a perception check for me.
Any bonuses from the NV, or I'm able to roll perception because I have the NV?
You're able to. Though you can take a plus two. That's fine.
All right.
Okay, there do appear to be additional silhouettes, people or something moving in the behind the wall. As you get closer, you can tell that they are human. They're not zombies. And there's a couple people moving back and forth, almost as if just on guard.
Okay. I would, you know, like, stop everyone, like, stop. And then just bring everyone to, like, the wall. We got movement up ahead. And then look at Peter. These some more of your hobos, possibly? Looks like they're on guard for something.
Judging by just what happened down the stairs, I'm not surprised.
Send word before they light us up?
Can I do whatever I know for, I'm thinking emissary, but that's not it. My brain isn't raining.
Diplomat or something?
Thank you. Yeah, that. I want to do whatever sort of customs they do for greeting to be able to get through here with my group.
Okay. How about...
And see if I recognize any of them.
So, are you...
It's kind of dark, I know.
Are you in the... The rats don't even, like, rely on, like, sight that much. So I don't know if the rolling a perception would really work. Do you have any way of seeing in the dark? Do you want to?
Yeah, I could. Magically create light for myself, like a flashlight, you know, okay. Magical.
Okay. Yeah. Go ahead and roll a ritual magic.
Adrian, I meant an actual flashlight.
Oh, I thought you were gonna like turn your light, your eyes into flashlights or something.
No.
Okay, so yeah, if you turn on a flashlight,
I turned my eyes into flashlights. They're really gonna let me through. I promise you.
So what are you doing?
I'm turning on a flashlight so I can walk over and greet them the way I know how to greet hobos.
Okay, well, they...
Can I do a shield on myself in case, like, they want to attack me? Because I go and greet them?
Yeah, you can.
I'm taking a position close to the wall with my night visions. Like, taking a knee close to the wall while Peter moves up, and I do have my rifle trained. But I'm trying to stay out of sight, which, in the darkness, hopefully helps.
Okay. So, what about Zach and Vincent? What are you two doing? Sam Riley, by the way, is holding position up at 14 to prevent anything from coming down after you guys. because I don't want to PC him.
If Zach sees Graves, like, kind of like, you know, have his weapon out and be ready for the possibility of something to go down, then he'll probably be like, oh yeah, I should do that too.
Okay. Do you have any kind of like, way of seeing in the dark, any night vision, or are you relying on just flashlights and others?
Can I spend some style points to say I have night vision goggles?
Yes, you can. You can spend a style point, and you've been outfitted by QB with a set of night vision goggles.
And, that is what I will do.
Okay, so you can now see, which is good.
I'm a whip out the Hello Kitty.
Whoa, what was that?
I said I'm a whip out the Hello Kitty.
Okay.
The Hello Kitty gun.
And hope that I don't shoot anyone.
For those who are paying attention, Vincent draws an enormous hand blaster with an engraving of Hello Kitty on the slide.
I'm pretty sure I can't see that right now.
You can't, because you're walking forwards towards the others. The doctor, are you in the back just taking a quick smoke?
Like, not in the back. Like, he's just, like, by everyone, just smoking. Like, he's not really preparing for a fight or anything, because at the end of the day, if he starts fighting, shit's gonna go downhill real fucking fast.
Yeah, that's true. So, Peter, roll for me. Never mind.
A diplomacy?
You can roll streetwise instead.
I also have, as I'm walking over, I'm thinking, maybe it's somebody else. Like, you know, the looters and the plunderers.
No, streetwise, please. Sorry.
Oh, streetwise.
Okay. You kind of call out, have your flashlight on. They don't, like, fire on you or anything, but you can tell one of them has a shotgun. The other is armed with probably a pistol, but it's in a big thick coat, so it's not visible. But they kind of exchange hurried whispers, and then one starts to run back, and the other... Go ahead.
As soon as I see them, I want to identify if they're at the Hobo Network or not.
Did you roll perception already?
No, I did not.
Go ahead.
Okay. Perception.
Yeah, these guys look like they are probably part of the Hobo Syndicate. And with an 8 perception, you can see the other guy is kind of runs not too far away, but near where the stairs are, and starts talking with more guys who are all busy doing something. And they seem to be more like Hispanic macho dudes.
Are all of them Hispanic?
These four guys that he went to go talk with are, yes. But okay. This is like, hey, stay where you are for me, buddy, okay? What you doing down here?
Taking the only safe path I know of to get from one place to another. What happened to, and I just threw out a name of somebody who's kind of high up with, like, where are they at? Because pretty sure whoever like I saw when I came through here last.
Mm-hmm. So I would have you roll like a diplomacy with a +4. So you might just need to roll a +4. No, I'll give you an empathy roll instead at a penalty, which is a
+2. I have a rank in.
Ooh. Then I'm not even. If you do have the
that's,
rank in the...
That's what I was... Because okay. I have rank 1 Hobo Network.
Okay, then... Like, then
I did stuff when I was in New York. Thank you very much.
roll an admin check then, +2.
That's what I thought you were going to go with, was admin. But my administration is not good because I actually don't have any levels in it.
but plus it's two. Okay. +2 because of your rank.
Dang. They don't know who this person I'm talking about is.
Yeah, he doesn't know. He's maybe too distracted, and he keeps looking over at his back and tells... You're pretty sure that he says for the other guys to shut up. That's like a hiss. Oh.
Okay, can I... At least that wasn't, like, anything. Can I say... I need to get through to station... To basically yeah. what the blockade I know on the other side to. They have. Yeah, I need to get through to the other station.
You picked a really bad time to come down here.
I could tell from just down the stairs.
What happened over there?
Are you deaf? Are you just stupid? You know the people who got shut up down the way?
Probably stupid, but I didn't hear anything.
Lucky you. You're still alive.
Here, just go through. Just pretend you didn't see anything.
Okay, I have a group with me.
How many?
Four? Wait, is the person at the that's waiting gonna be following after Adrian?
He's staying at station 14.
Okay.
He's keeping it clear.
Then four.
Geronimo, just we got some visitors coming. Just don't worry about it. And then you hear, do you speak Spanish?
I don't know what language I speak. I think we went over. Yeah, we didn't actually go over my languages. I have four languages I could know. maybe.
You have 4 points, so yeah. If you want to choose that or not, whether you speak Spanish or not, I'll need to know right now.
Sure, I speak Spanish.
You speak fluent Spanish or partial Spanish or poquito
probably
Spanish?
Probably level 2.
Okay. That's conversational Spanish, which means you hear a bunch of curse words, and with your 8 perception, you also hear kind of like a noise, if that came through. But this guy lets you in through the blockade if you want to come.
I yell back to my group, "Hey guys, we're clear. Can I do a perception just to make sure that they're not going to do anything? They don't look like they're about to do something stupid."
If you make another perception check now that you're close.
Yeah, that's what I was planning. I don't know if they're trying to do something stupid or not, but...
You can see that the four Mexican guys are all, like, wrestling and pinning something to the ground. With 3 perception, you can't really tell exactly what it is, but it's, like, another guy or something.
Yeah, not too suspicious at all, definitely. I don't need to see anything here, and I move along. Nothing to see here. Let's go.
I'll pop up from my knee and begin walking down the tunnel because I was a ways away with the group and make my way towards the hobo area.
Okay. So, Peter, are you going down the tunnel further?
I go past the group and kind of just past the group so I can look back and make sure that the rest of us get through.
Okay. Vincent, what is your outer garments? Like, what do you look like? Are you wearing body armor and stuff? Are you more civilian looking, or?
I don't think I have body armor. I'm pretty sure I'm just in random looking, not quite mechanic clothes, but mechanic clothes with
just kind of normal. So
mysterious substances on them.
Okay, if you go through, go ahead and roll me a perception check, which would be primary or secondary attribute. So it's at the top of the page.
Did that roll? That didn't roll. No, it's just not rolling.
Graves, as you're, I think, coming in next, you do look a lot more military, right?
Oh, I'm in full-blown military.
Yeah. The hobo guard with the sawed-off is like, "Who are you guys?" And as you get closer, you don't need to roll perception. You recognize these 4 guys, but you can roll perception for something else.
Sure.
And then, Zach, as you're coming in too, you kind of more look like a firefighter guy, right? You've got some body armor, but you don't look necessarily military. Is that right?
Yeah, he's more firefighter-looking. Mm-hmm.
So you can roll perception for me, and the doc, as you come in also, you can please roll perception.
We all know the doc looks like the Fed.
Okay, nothing to see here, just two cars passing each other, coming and going. Vincent and the doc, as you are passing through, you both see these four cartel members holding somebody down to the ground. Both of you see that this guy that they have, his flesh is rotted, and as his head turns and he kind of tries to bite with its zombified jaw, they are holding down a live zombie and trying to like zip tie its hands behind its back. And the one guy, Julio, he's got him in a neck hold with, he's holding a muzzle, almost like changed from being for a dog, and like they modified it to fit for a human. And he's just like waiting for you guys all to leave before he tries to do anything next.
Graves, not seeing the zombie, but seeing the group, would probably have his rifle like slung over his chest, you know, with the sling, and just seeing the struggle but not seeing the zombie, would like break off from exiting the tunnel and begin walking towards them and be like, what the fuck is this?
Don't worry about it, man.
Vincent would just look at it and just be like, that's gross, feed it the cheetah.
I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
Would any of these guys be recognizable to the doc? From when they were in, like, dealing with the cartel and stuff.
You could... No, honestly, you wouldn't. You would not have seen these guys before.
Right.
This is not Abel, the guy that you guys saved in Mexico. That's not him. I think they might be the same token, but these are all, like, different guys. You can roll a... I don't think it'd be supernatural lore, necessarily. What would be a skill to recognize like tattoos? That'd be streetwise, kind of. If you have streetwise, you can roll streetwise.
Yeah, I'm good.
Graves would respond with, "What happened to search and gather? Why are we wrestling? Oh shit!" Now actually being up close with the NPCs, yeah. Seeing the.
Yeah, you can see they're wrestling a zombie. They've got him contained, but it's not 100% contained. Like, they're repressing him with body weight and zip ties.
I think, instinctively, Graves probably pulls out his pistol.
Whoa, don't shoot, we got this! Now they start speaking in Spanish to you. We got this, buddy, just go on, we're fine.
Why do you got this? He responds back in Spanish.
We didn't ask you questions. What's all with all the questions now? And then the one guy gets up off the legs, and you can see he's like pulls up his own AK-47. He's not holding it at anyone, but he's now holding it. And the zombie is a little bit less loose now.
In Spanish, Graves would ask, are we bringing this back with us? Has Abel asked for this?
See,
I'd like to know what's happening when we're leaving the city.
Yes, this, we're bringing him back with us. Look, his name is Charlie. And then he pulls on the hair and the zombie's a little like, rah!
Graves takes like the biggest like sigh, like what the fuck, who am I working with, and just says, we're gonna have to talk about this later. Are you confident that you're going to be able to live and survive through this ordeal?
Yeah, maybe if you stopped chatting and gave us a hand, we could get this thing ready.
I'll walk up and go put my full boot's weight on the leg that Abner got up off of.
Okay. Abner will then... What's everybody else doing in this? Have you guys
Because Graves just broke off and suddenly had a... suddenly having conversation and helping these guys.
I'm looking through my bag for Cheetos.
Okay. You spend the
I want to see if the zombie will eat it.
You can have a Cheeto bag.
Oh, sweet.
Dr. Desdemona and Peter and Zach, you all roll perception checks, please.
Okay. I see everything.
You see that, and you also see Geronimo and Hobo One. Can you see all their names and stuff? I think you can.
Yeah.
The two hobos are like weighing bags that they have been given, apparently, in counting their payments.
Can I try to throw a Cheeto at the zombie's mouth?
I would say to the hobos, food's a lot more valuable down here. But whatever.
This isn't going to end forever. You know, people are talking about a cure. Some sort of miracle cure.
Gotta stay alive till then.
It's safe enough. It's safe enough. Doc gonna have a stop point. The Cheeto kind of bounces in the mouth of the zombie. It does not seem to react to it much, and it kind of breaks and falls to the ground. As Abner comes around, having produced a hood from one of the bags and from his backpack, and he pulls the hood over the head of the zombie, and then they put a belt thing around the neck, tie it, and then they put the muzzle on around the face of the zombie on above the thing, so it's pretty well contained as best as they can tell. There, see? Good as new. Safe.
Why?
Gotta think with your big brain. Don't worry, okay. we won't let Charlie bite anybody. Roll an empathy check.
I think the dog gets what they're putting down.
Yeah, pretty much everybody, the person who's talking is Julia, to you, saying that, and the other three all kind of smirk and chuckle. Doc, do you speak any Spanish?
No, but why would they be here, grabbing a zombie? The dog gets don't need to be spoken.
Yeah, exactly. The dog gets it. Yeah. I was gonna say basically, you might not know the words, but yeah, you can see what they're doing.
I mean, to be fair, Graves might know what they're doing. It doesn't mean he approves of what they're doing.
Julio shrugs. Hey, look, everybody wins. This sells major bucks on the black market. They get their drugs. You get to come into your city behind the cover of the military, and your friends, you'll get them out, whatever you're doing.
You talk too much.
Well,
it's time to go.
He just salutes to you with two fingers, sayonara.
Bring it back to the boat. We'll see what else is around the city.
Yeah, we're leaving at dawn. We'll wait for you till dawn.
Yeah, understood. Just keep that thing restrained.
No, it's not going anywhere.
If I come back to an empty boat, nothing but blood, well, that'll be on you.
Well, we'll be seeing you.
Yeah. At dawn. And I'll just watch them walk off. Do they have one of those zookeeper lion things to keep it at arm's length.
They're like dragging it as if it's just an unconscious prisoner or something, by kind of like arms tied behind its back and just dragging him from there.
The doc will look over at Graves and goes, "The friends of yours?"
Yeah, you could say something like that. Acquaintances. Well,
if you want them to live, you might want to tell them to take a knife and stab and puncture its lungs. They'll make a lot less sounds.
You know, cover of a zombie on them, though, might actually help them more than screw them. And personally, between the two of us, if this gets them killed, and I'm whispering this to the doc, then that's on them. I'm not in charge of them. I'm just in charge to get them back.
Does my 10 perception hear this?
Yeah.
Peter doesn't really care that much. He's just curious if he does hear it or not. I'm curious, rather.
Yeah. With a 10 perception, you can pick up that the two hobos have a lot of payments in various narcotics of their choice. And the crew with the zombie, they're like planning basically to just go back to their departure point and lay low. And then you hear the conversation between Graves and the doc.
Yeah, Graves, what Graves is telling the doc is basically, you know, I brought them here, but if they die, that's on them.
As is any man's death.
And then, can I see what drugs the hobos have? Do they have, like, what I would need to make more sanity stims? Gotta know, man. I gotta know.
He has an itch again.
Yeah. Is Adrian dead? Hello?
Oh, I was muted, but I also don't see your roll.
I didn't hear a roll.
Oh, you didn't ask for
that's
one.
That's why. Craft medicine. Sorry. That explains why you didn't roll. Sorry,
yeah,
my mic
that
was
would
up.
Be it.
Craft medicine. I'll put a stop point into this.
Priorities, right?
Eh, you know what? You're right. 2 stop points.
You get 1 free stop point back for that. That was funny.
Oh, only 2. That's a shame.
Without directly going up and asking what they have, you just know that it's in like wrapped bags. But whatever it is, they've got a lot of it.
Okay, I need to check something real quick. One momento. Alright. Can Graves walk up to the hobos? Pull out, like, because I'm looking. Graves has wealth 1, which is a lot of money. Can Graves walk up to the hobos, pull out like $500, and just say, "Give me whatever, you know, amount of drugs this gets me," like in like pointing to the vast amount, like, yeah, give me bits of everything.
So you can roll either streetwise or just a flat admin check plus your wealth bonus plus 2, or diplomacy if you wanted to do that too. Any of those.
So, admin, diplomacy, or streetwise?
Yes.
Plus two my rank.
Yeah. Not rank, just wealth.
That's what I meant, yeah.
Yeah.
So plus 2 and then plus 1 from wealth rank 1. Or plus two... Oh, plus two from having wealth rank one.
Exactly. That's okay. That sounded very complicated. I'm sorry. It's just okay. roll one skill check with a plus two bonus.
I will do admin plus two, and you know what? You priorities.
If you have a synergy, you can take one from any of those others.
I have diplomacy.
At least four ranks? Or four
total? Yep.
Then yeah, you can have a plus two from that.
And I will, you know, priorities, I put a style point. So, for a bonus of five total.
Yep.
Five sus.
They snatch up your 500 bucks and quickly deal some of the good stuff to you, and you have ingredients to make more stims.
Perfect.
Zach totally that. Would see this and think that Graves has a drug problem now.
I'm just going to put in my inventory various drugs to make more sanity stims.
Yeah, ingredients.
You know,
various drugs.
During the last game when we were doing that like drug deal in the back there, I was like, you know, that would be funny if that happened. And all of a sudden it did.
Mm-hmm. Like I said, the real villain,
I was like, well, that escalated quickly.
The real villain of my Quantum Black games. Addiction. Yeah, so with that concluded, this guy walks over to Peter and says, what did you mean earlier about there being shots earlier? We didn't hear anything.
Can I get, how long ago? The bodies were still warm when I went there, so it would have been
They weren't warm, they were cold. It had been like a day.
Oh, it's been a day or so since the last hallway was attacked. The entrance is open.
They look at each other like in a little bit of shock. We've been waiting here for about 2 days for the cartel guys. Nobody came
two
past
days?
Here.
And you heard nothing?
No.
You need to get your hearing checked.
Could Graves pipe in and say, as someone who likes to be informed, and as someone pretty close to the cartel, what's your business? Maybe I can get you a better cut.
I chuckle at him saying he's close to the cartel after that drug deal just went down.
They just wanted a safe passage. Let's capture one of the infected.
Is that all they said?
They were just going to pay us to get them in, line up the perfect spot, just up the... We were only up in the streets for a little bit trying to find it.
Did you open the pathway?
We opened this one, where we're at now. We opened, but it's closed again. We lured one of those walkers up close, and then once the cartel guys came, we just let them handle it.
Hmm. If you have extra time to close up a path, the one over there could use some work.
I think we better get back to the safe zones.
That would be smart.
Where are you guys headed?
I don't even know at this point.
That's on a need-to-know basis.
maybe we should come with you guys. You guys, the army?
You think this guy's the army?
I just paid you $500 to buy your drugs. I understand that I told you that we're the military before, but who do you think I am?
But we were the blackout zone, man. Anything goes down here.
Just go down and go get your men. Go bury them. Go close the hole.
Okay, fine, whatever.
Or go back to your safe zone, either way. The dead are dead.
I mean, maybe we better just hole up here. We'll go. Alright, good luck, guys, and don't use it all in one go, okay? Never mind.
Graves is just doing like the John Travolta meme of like, what the fuck is this?
They leave.
We continue on our way after that fancy drug deal that just went down, man.
Just like turn on my heel and begins moving again.
Continuing on.
Literally 30 seconds after they get from earshot, the doc mutters, "It suddenly smells better in here."
Knowing the doc, I think Graves would lag to just walk beside him and just kind of just from their experiences in, you know, Guatemala, would just ask, simply straightforwardly ask him, "Do you want it?" Doctor to doctor, knowing what we can make, do you want any?
Well, let's wait till we get to the warehouse. We might have other supplies that we could add to the batch.
Understood, Doc.
Okay. As you get up to the final station, which is located very close to where the warehouse is, you make a quick check around the few walkers that are in eyeshot further down the streets. You're able to either ignore, or if anyone wanted to engage, I would need to know that. But otherwise, you arrive at the warehouse. You're now on the streets. And up ahead, you see this public storage for rent, storage units for rent building. It's boarded up and glass around, but yeah.
I will double check my phone messages for, like, you know, the directions that Green gave me to, like, where the real stuff is at.
Okay. Can you see the red outline on your map?
Yes.
Yes. So,
The building is so big, but the entire almost right half of the building has been repurposed and sealed off and is Green's warehouse. So if you access it through, you have to go through one of the storage hallways, and you would know that once you get over to here, there are three primary entrances that can be opened up, and then there's a access into like the parking garage or whatever, where you can bring a freight elevator down and load unload in relative privacy.
And you said the front entrance was boarded?
It's got like someone who's maybe has tried to come in here and hole up in the beginning of the pandemic, but it's been since broken and the doors are not locked anymore. They're just boarded with glass around them.
Okay, so they seem like you can push them open.
Yes.
All right, I'll very carefully push open the entry doors with my rifle at the ready.
Okay, roll stealth and perception.
Nah, I'm gonna save my style points. I mean, yeah, I have no ranks in stealth.
So priorities, you know, right?
Yeah, priorities for the drugs. You need the priorities.
Yep, right there.
I mean, for one dice, 50-50 chance.
So, you push the door a little bit with the barrel of your rifle. It creaks loudly. And inside you hear and see head swivel. And I will have everybody please roll initiative.
It wasn't me, it was the door. I can't be blamed.
Yeah. Do we need to click on our tokens first?
Yep. Yes, but if you already rolled, okay. I can add you.
I didn't roll. I just have trouble with my scroll button.
I just need to get you a new mouse.
Yeah, my mouse sucks.
Oh, I'm in the wrong layer, that's why. Okay. Everybody in, I think?
Someone's missing.
Yeah, Justin's character's not on, because he used his phone to roll his initiative.
Here, I'll add him. So 5.
or three.
I saw five. No, did he roll twice? Mm. Oh, that was Vince.
I rolled a three, right?
Not Justin. Yeah, you rolled a three.
And then I think because Zach came up under the five, so it might just be using the wrong
name
in the chat.
Well,
oh, yeah, it's because when Justin typed earlier, he did it on the laptop and he clicked the thing, so it says as Vincent instead of Zach.
So, Graves, you are the first to act.
Okay. I don't shout, but I definitely say contact, and I will back up a little bit. One, two. Or, I mean, you know, one more square off map, because I have five movement.
I can give you that square in a second.
And then... Hey, extra squares. And then, that very first one that I see, as much as I want to target the runner, I would just go for the first one that I would see, which would be this guy. And I'm just going to fire a shot off.
Okay, and is your weapon suppressed?
It is indeed silenced.
Okay, so go ahead and roll a stealth check plus four.
Okay.
Actually, I didn't think these rules out that well, actually. It'd be more of an innate roll. I don't think it would be based off of your actual ability of stealth, because it'd just be flat noise.
Well, that would be much better.
So I'm just going to say it's a four. The bonus is four, so that's what the roll would have been.
Okay.
And these are close, so you are good at whoosh, your rifle craps.
Perhaps it craps out? No, that's not good.
It cracks. Go ahead and make your attack on the zombie.
Not full auto, just single fire.
Okay. Its flesh blows out behind it, but it's still there.
Alright, that is my turn.
Move and attack. Zach. You hear Graves go contact, and then there's a rifle shot.
Gotta see how much I can move, because I never remember that.
Your move is 8.
It loaded for you before it loaded for me.
I've got everything open.
Oh, nice. Yeah, I really should too, but... Oh well. Okay, so...
These memes, I just saw them.
Did you see the leader? I saw it.
Go. And... So I guess line of sight into here is through the doorway?
Yeah, you've got to get through the door, one of the two doors, to get line of sight.
Back over a decent way. Now I was seeing if I could see this one back here.
Yep, that one is... looking over at the door as well.
Yep, okay. I'm just gonna wait forever for my sheet to load. I'ma shoot at it with my bow.
Okay, and this is the first time he's being attacked, so... Ooh. How do you want to kill this?
Much like the other one, just a precision, like, aim, release, bam, through the eyeball. Dead.
Yeah, one shot, one kill, straight through the brain, the zombie drops down to the ground. Very nice. The good doc.
The doc is going to move to, right here, and then is going to Essentially just kind of like kneel down and try to stay out of the line of fire. Out of game, he is activating his guardian field, so within 10 feet of him, you're getting a plus 2 to your defense.
Excellent, excellent. So that is move action, right?
Correct.
So, Peter.
Can Peter see anything from here? Oh, or do I need to hit that door section? Probably not.
You can see there's a corpse on the ground. And it looks it's been, people. It looks like, yeah, its guts are out. And
I don't want to get in front of, can I just move over to there? Mm-hmm. And then can I see in further?
Yeah, the door, I imagine Graves kind of like, when you shut contact, he kind of opened the door at least enough to like, see and shoot through.
Can definitely, I do like full shove.
Spell on this zombie back there.
Okay, yeah, the one behind the counter as it pokes up blood and stuff hanging out from its jaw. You see it? Go ahead.
Hold on, let me try magic. There we go.
I don't think it can actually. That's passive. I think this also gets a penalty because it is magic. So how do you kill that one?
Basically, you know the mummy, how like the bugs go under the skin?
Ooh,
imagine that, but like rats just crawl up the skin and just these lumps and then scratches come.
Gross.
And then just blood everywhere.
Yeah, it like drops back down the counter, and you can see that there's rat swarms all over it.
And then they disappear. They're not actually there. It just. I thought of a new way to kill zombies. Yep.
Great. I forgot my bane with zombies. 1, 2, 3, 4. Double move. 1, 2, 3. Both of you roll charisma checks, Zach and Peter. Best one doesn't win, but also wins.
I'm so beautiful. You see this face? I could be a model for
Rogue. Zach is unlucky. It kind of moves forwards as you're reloading your next arrow, and it growls at you but can't move because it is double moved. 1, 2, 3, 4. Same for this one. Vincent. Is this the first time you've seen a zombie up close? I think the ones in the alleyway from last session you didn't really get up close for.
It is definitely my first time seeing one of these things that close.
Give me a sanity roll.
That'll be boy.
The top of your skills.
This is everyone's dump stat, is the willpower, so you know.
Rolling, supposedly.
Charisma and will. Both of those are typical dump stats, which is really funny.
Oh, there it goes.
You take 2 points of sanity loss from seeing zombie. This one that came out is like has skin dripping down from its face from where it had been eating something inside, and so it's very frightening. And they're swarming around Zach a little bit, and that is very unsettling to you. You lose 2 sanity.
Okay, how do I do that?
I just did it for you.
Okay, cool. Alright, these things are gross, so I'm gonna move here, and I'm gonna pull out Hello Kitty, and Hello Kitty's gonna say hello.
Okay.
The first zombie that's right there in front of me.
Before you do that, I would have to have you cancel the move because it's an action to draw the pistol if you don't have quick draw. So you can just shoot from there and still do your
thing. Hope I don't shoot Ambrose in the head.
Wait, quick, actually pause real quick. I think Todd and Pi, you probably know the rules a little bit best. Can you do that if you don't move?
It's, or
is
it just
it's a flat action and the move is its own thing, right? I don't know if you can if you haven't had it drawn already. If you spend a style point.
I know in the past we've ruled it that, like, you know, if you sacrifice your movement,
that's
kind of
what I thought.
Let's see. Standard actions are straightforward and can be resolved relatively quickly.
I think technically the move is its own thing and the action is its own thing. But I mean, you've been going through New York, so if you just spend a style point, you can say it was already drawn.
Yeah, I feel like he had Hello Kitty out during the last.
Actually,
thing,
so yeah, he never said to put it away. You did draw that already, so never mind. You don't even have to spend it. You're good. You're good. You can move and attack.
Put that out there.
Okay. Okay. So you shoot it. Roll. Actually, I have to roll something.
Mm-hmm. Him rolling stuff does not make me happy.
Oh yeah, my deagle is not silenced, by the way. It is a deagle.
I know, that's why I didn't have you roll anything.
That's why he's rolling. We're screwed. That's what that means.
Yeah, this takes a big old chunk of flesh outside of its face. So it loses an ear and part of its skull and an eyeball. Its jaw's hanging even lower, but it's still up.
You're gross.
Sorry. Rated R warning. This game is not for little kids. Alright, where's my turn order? Next up is Graves again, top of the round.
So yeah, there are attack actions, defense actions, and move actions. Sorry, they're all three separate things.
That's what I thought. But we're good. Graves, go ahead.
Okay. So that was a loud shot.
Yeah, 50 AE. Boom.
Alright, I'm going to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 right here to not risk really shooting anyone, and I'm going to try to pop this one.
Okay.
Single shot again, not full auto.
Okay, and that is a lot of damage to it. It is going to go down. How do you kill it?
Sweet. It is a just quickly pull up the scope, aim to its head, pop it right in the skull.
Zach, I feel it's appropriate to have you roll a sanity, but I'll give you a plus one because you've been through this situation a couple hours ago and you made it out okay.
Yay! Slow loading sheet! Yay!
Top of the skills.
Top of the skills. Oh yeah. I always forget what that is. Where that is.
Okay, you're okay. You can move and attack, or you can total attack if you wanted to just stay there in front of it.
So does quick draw apply to swapping weapons?
Yes.
Sweet.
You do have quick draw, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Yep, so you can swap out.
Yep, that is what I'm gonna do, so I can... Hold on. Things I wanted to move where I can see. There we go. Yeah, okay. Had to make sure it wasn't the zombie in front of me that was dead, so I wasn't saying I was shooting that one, and then... Anyways. Gonna shoot the one in front of me.
Go ahead. And this is going to be with the Glock, so at your point blank is plus two. With a pistol.
Plus two. Sorry, the computer is being the weird.
It's at one hit point already. Okay, you kill this one as well.
Yay!
And you know the horse word.
Done, done, done.
Okay.
Another one bites the dust.
So we're out of turn order.
I wonder how many zombies.
So, I'm gonna do what the doc would have done on his next turn anyways, just because we went loud there. He's gonna reach into his pocket, he's gonna pull out a smoke bomb, like a smoke grenade, pull the pin and drop it at his feet as he enters the building. Okay. To cover our retreat into the building.
I wanna send my rats out. Outside and inside, just to kind of see what's going on out there in case we alerted anyone to our presence, and if there's anything else in the building that we should be aware of.
Okay.
If we're not everyone, in order, like, is, once, if yeah. that's...
No, you cool. can you can all move.
Once okay, everyone cool. enters the building, Graves is gonna reshut the door, and if there's anything, if there's any chairs in this entryway, he'll place a chair on the door.
Can I use an ancient spell called Hold Door?
Yeah, you can.
Sweet.
If you're doing that, as you yeah. begin to cast your ritual, go ahead and make a spell check.
Can I set up one of my custom bombs at the doorway?
Inside or outside?
Inside.
Okay. Yeah, you may. So...
Okay. I'm just setting one of the noise makers there.
Okay.
By the way, the door's not going to open for anyone but me if you try to open. Just putting that out
so,
there.
You are successful. Both of you are.
Oh, good. Excellent.
And then Graves puts the chair in as a finishing touch.
Yep, just... I was probably bringing the chair back as you were finishing the spell, and I was like, you know what, I'm just going to put it there for extra.
So, what does the door look like with your spell on it? Just same as everything, or are there, like, rats kind of swarming all around it, or just
looks if, normal? If I have, honestly, I probably do have a slight glow of energy, but it's more like a dark glow. Rather, the door just looks slightly darker than it did earlier. Maybe, like, it has more texture to it that isn't quite what the door's made out of. Like, almost like a smoke layer is over it, but it looks like, you know, soot and air pollution.
Mm-hmm. I personally have this image of, like, a meagmas swarm of rats in the form of a person literally holding the door there, but...
Whatever you want to pick.
These guys look very clearly eaten by zombies, right?
Yeah, there's not even like a face much left. It's just gore.
Did the doc tell us this is a Quantum Black facility? I forget.
He did.
Okay. Should I look at these guys? Do they look like Quantum Black workers, or do they just look like regular warehouse workers?
Rule an investigation and add your rank bonus.
Okay.
People running away from the apocalypse.
Investigation plus two.
You can tell that, yeah, this guy looks like... He doesn't have any, like, badges for Quantum Black, but he looks like he's supposed to be working here, but it's not branded the storefront.
Okay, so Graves would turn around to the doc and say, looks like this might be some of ours.
The too bad under his breath as he like walks over and like gives it the heel and kind of like crushes its head a little bit, making sure that it doesn't come back up.
More paperwork.
Graves will like check both bodies just to make sure, you know, they're both quantum black. And then if this is a storage facility, can I go into one of these back rooms and see if there are any leftover like storage keys for the non-quantum black section?
Yeah, if you go through, you don't even have to roll an investigation. There are several, and they're all labeled too, so you'd be able to find it's L15 or whatever.
I will. I'll grab the key ring.
Two back or whatever.
Yeah, I'll just grab the key ring, and if there's like a what's that thing called? Why can't I think of it? It's like the thing that doctors carry on. They clip papers to it when they walk in the room. Clipboard. If there's a clipboard of the various storages and what keys go to, I'll take that as well, because I'm gonna go looting. This is now turned into a looting session, gang.
Okay. Doc, are you opening the door and going through there? It's not locked or anything.
Actually, it's a QB version game of QB version of Hoarders.
Yeah.
Or what's the one where they look at lockers and they like
Storage Wars?
Yeah, that one.
I used to watch that all the damn time.
For any materials for
I'm muted.
Making things.
Any materials for explosion things? Is that what you said?
I said making thing, but explosion things is what I'm looking for. Yes.
Doc, what were you saying when you were muted?
Yeah, do I see that body up there?
As you step into the right area, yes.
I will look back and kind of like wave my hand, but like kind of place it up towards Graves and be like, it looks like we're not quite like in the clear. Like, keep your guard up.
Will do.
Sorry, go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
You said that here, yeah, were interested.
Yeah, each hallway has a access door that you'd be able to open with the code.
Alright, the doc's gonna, like, seeing that puppy over there, he's just gonna kind of slouch this way and start heading towards that one.
Okay. Yeah, looks clear.
My rats that were looking around, did they find anything?
Not in here, but I didn't hear you say anything about sending rats into the hallways.
Oh, I said inside and outside.
So if you send your rats, let me give you that token back. Whoa, I just hit a different thing. No, I don't want to log into Outlook. Give me back Roll 20. Sorry.
It's not your fault. Computers.
Outlook is the overlord.
It's the Uber's trying to hack me.
It's the Asians. They're going to turn it into Hello Kitty Outlook.
Okay. I think you have access to this, Becca. Put your rats where you want to go look.
Yay! There's some out. No, I don't have access to that. This?
I can move your rats for some reason.
I can't.
I put it on all.
I don't know what just happened, but I think the kids are outside playing with a ball, because it just hit my window.
Dude, that could have been bad.
It just scared me.
Oh. That was me, I was aiming at it.
Dang. Justin!
I told Cthulhu to do it for me.
Cthulhu's giggling downstairs.
Yeah, I hope noise cancellation works, because, my gosh, our kids are way
hear
too loud.
Oh, good.
Okay, you see another body at the other end of the hallway.
Are you talking to me or to Todd?
To Peter.
Okay, Peter.
Because you're
Peter's
piloting
still
your
to,
rats, right?
He's still trying to move his rats, but they're not working.
You should be right here.
Oh, that's his. It's like an X'd out body. Wait, who's the light green?
The rats are on top of it.
Oh, dang. Okay, yeah, no wonder. I was trying to do the ones at a different spot. Cool. They're gonna go down this way first. Do I know that we want to go this way first?
Oh, the dock's going that way. The okay. dock. Do you continue down your hallway too?
Yeah.
Okay. The badge, or the code, as you open the secret compartment for the code is, there's no power. And by the way, there's no power in this building either, so it's darkish. Graves, are you doing anything? Oh, and Beck, stop yeah. for a second and roll perception.
I would turn this corner, you know, seeing it clear, and, whatever side is the entrance, I don't know if it's this side. Is this side the would be the entrance to the storage container?
It would be, I think, in the main hallways on the faddish side.
Okay, so I would move up then, and I would peek the corners here.
Okay, it's clear. As you're and moving, you can roll stealth, and you can have a situational +4, because I'm imagining you're, like, sweeping it really carefully.
Yeah. So, situational +4.
Dr. Desdemona, the answer is yes, because you have a special thing.
Four and four.
Okay. Carry on.
If I'm just gonna start trying keys, then I'm just gonna, you know, go storage container by storage container, and you know, if this is one of them, I try a key, I bust out the key ring, try it open.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, they're all labeled. The ones that you have, they open up, and whether there's stuff inside or not. Peter,
you can give me a list after the game. Oh dear God.
Yeah, you hear movement outside and, like, the doors rattling as you're kind of jerked away from the senses of the rats for a second as you realize there's a thin wall separating you between the horde.
I'm going to stealthily go. There's no windows, right?
The entry does have windows, but they've been boarded over, and the glass is broken, so it's literally just plywood.
I whisper to Zach that giant horde of zombies, they shouldn't get through the door, but... And I go get Boomy Guy, who's loud, because, you know...
my speakers suck, so when you whispered, I didn't really hear much of what you said.
I informed you that there's a bunch of zombies out there, right? I realize there were zombies there, Adrian?
Yeah, you can hear them.
Okay.
There's a horde outside. Some brought in from noise.
Can I stealthily go get Vincent quietly? I'm going to stealthily go over to him very, very quietly. We are not here. We are not here. And I tell Vincent, there's a horde of zombies right outside the door that I locked. But yeah, there's a bunch of them. And I don't like it. And you make boom. So make boom if they get in.
Oh, boom now?
Not yet. Not yet. If they get in. Oh. If they get in.
Oh.
Zach, are you doing anything specific?
Yeah, after Peter has alerted Zach to the zombies, Zach is going to go find the doc so he can tell him that, you know, we're starting to get swarmed.
Okay.
Hey, can I reach the ceiling?
Hold on, what was that?
Can I reach the ceiling?
No.
How tall up is the ceiling?
This is like a storage facility. This is probably like 12-foot ceilings. With, like, the suspended lights.
Oh, so it's... Okay. After I tell Vincent, I go and I find Graves. Tell Graves, because okay. Graves should know that, too.
So, we'll pause for you for a second. So, Graves, how many containers do you wish to open? And do you want to mark is going over drawing tools?
Yeah.
Which ones?
So Graves is going down this line here, mm-hmm. and I imagine probably gets to these two by the time Peter gets to them.
Okay. So pause that for a second. Those gates when you're opening them are like roll cages, right? So roll a perception.
Sure. 4. Me and fours.
Okay, I need to check their speed for their runners. That's not right.
I'd say I'm being careful about it, but there's no being careful about opening shutters.
And you suck at stealth anyways, so you know.
Hey, I got a 4 stealth before.
That was actually quite impressive. 10. I was impressed by that, because Peter has labeled you as loud guy. And you and Vincent both are loud guys. He's louder, but you know.
So maybe I was a bit quiet opening the shutters.
3, 4, 5, 6.
Just a bit.
7, 8, 9. Okay, roll stealth. You can have a free stealth check.
Okay. Regular stealth or with the plus 4?
With the gates, you can have plus 2 for the gates.
All right. I'll put a style into it.
Drugs and being quiet.
Yeah, drugs and being quiet. It's not the best, but I'm probably not going to beat their perception.
As you roll up the cage, I will have you roll initiative. And Peter and Zach and everybody can roll initiative.
Do I manage to do that last thing I put in chat before we are in initiative or not?
Yeah, you can have set that up and then you're coming out of the room.
Yay.
The dock. You get a text back from Green that there should be a manual override just above the door. He's not sure if there's a generator in the building. There's a generator inside his warehouse, but just to open the door, you'll have to do it manually. So he tells you kind of like how to open the door through like a backup roundabout way.
All right. I'm going to try to use the manual override.
Okay. It opens once you do that. So, this one opens. All right.
The dock will step through. He'll look to see if it looks like he can use the manual, like, override to, like, reshut it.
Yeah, it's basically unlocks like a lever, which can be accessed on both sides, kind of to open and close the secret compartment.
All right. Ambrose is gonna look over at Zach, who I'm pretty sure saw him like open the door, and he's gonna be like, tell the others how to get like onto the other side, and he's gonna shut the door.
Zach, the door.
How callous! In your face. I feel like that was a style point.
Yeah, I think the doc has been really gaining a lot of style points, and I'm scared of what he's gonna do with these.
And that would pretty much be my turn.
Yeah.
I guess. Zach is gonna start walking and looking for his other team members so he could tell them, you know, where the dock is, you know. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Yeah, I think my move was 8.
See, I told the perfect person.
Yeah, your move sucks.
Okay, Peter,
Peter is going to go at his normal speed so he could kind of keep his quiet. Wait, what? One, two. Graves! There's a horde of zombies! Outside the door! We should probably catch up with the doctor at this point. Can I get a perception at this point?
Yeah, you can roll perception.
Yeah.
You hear running footsteps down the hall to your right side.
And I say, oh crap! And I kind of ready myself for whatever the heck is going to come around the side. Because I don't necessarily know if I'm going to walk around to see it myself.
Okay.
You know?
So Graves. The first one is... carries a bunch of like furniture. There's like couches and stuff in here, so furniture. The second one is mostly empty, but there are a couple like of those crates and bins in here. It looks like there's tools. These small ones, this one is empty, and then this one here is going to be, let me think. Let me get back to you on this one.
All right.
Did you already roll perception?
I did. I got a 4.
4. So you hear the clatter of footsteps down the room behind you, and as Peter's coming up, kind of distracts you a little bit. You look at him, and then you look down, and you see the two zombie runners charging down.
Okay. Graves would probably say, well, we got more here, and if I can look down this corner from where I am... I would like to full auto into this first run.
Okay, that's a total attack for full auto.
So auto fire. Most firearms can only be fired accurately once or twice per combat turn. Full auto fire. Your character fires 20 or more bullets at a single target and gains +3 auto fire bonus to his attack level.
I believe that's on top of a +2 for total attack, isn't it?
Total attack is something different from what I'm reading. There's rapid fire, there's flurry. Yeah, this is auto fire. This is its own thing for a automatic weapon.
Okay, gotcha.
So your character fires 20 or more bullets at a single target and gains a +3 auto fire bonus to his roll. So I will roll with a +3 bonus.
Going to okay, that shreds it. Hold on, took out 7 damage. With 20 plus, basically you mag dump him essentially, so it just like tumbles down on itself.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to need a reload after this. I don't have that many bullets left in the round.
Okay.
Can you... You can attack, move, and move attack. Move is its own thing.
You can move and attack, or attack and then move, unless you have a talent to split it up.
Okay. Because I would fire down, and then I would back down this hallway a little bit. Not to the full corner, but just to the back, and I'm watching this way. I'm cross-firing with Peter.
Okay. Where's my measuring tool? So that's exactly 10. So it comes running around, turning, and distance is its enemy. I cannot get attacks off on you as it runs directly up to you. Vincent, as you're coming up, you hear the machine gun go off.
Does it look like anything's making it through or, like, banging on the door?
If you're watching back here...
Yeah.
It doesn't look like anything's getting through, no.
They're
pressing up against, like, the boards of the windows and stuff, but they're not really forcing them boards off, and then the front door, which would have been the access point, is very well sealed with the spell.
Okay, I'm just gonna, like, come up to the doorway, and how far away is the doorway from the other doorway?
From where?
Man, this is not working very well. I'm trying to measure from pretty much the doorway where I'm at to the door with the zombies.
25 feet.
Can I throw something that far?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I just want to stand in the doorway to leave this room, in case I need to leave this room. And I just want to have my Molotov out. Oops, I did not mean to click the bullet.
No, you're fine. For you, just so you know, athletics is the way you would throw grenades or handheld weapons, so that's the skill that you want to look at if you're going to throw anything handheld.
Where is that at?
It'd be under skills.
Okay, I found it.
Dr. Desdemona, okay. If you can roll perception.
Well, there are a couple of style points in that. Four, why not?
So, just curious, why am I below the zombies on the turn order when I roll higher than them?
What'd you roll?
I rolled a three.
Huh, maybe I got put in afterwards. I fixed it.
I rolled a seven.
So, despite the gunfire going off in the hallways beyond you, in here it feels very still, and it's the quietness, and I mean you hear like the shouting of and the machine gun, but in here the silence is disturbed as if something just moves, and perhaps it's just your senses are very in tune, but you hear a gentle footstep, very light, beginning to come closer to you down the first branch of the hallway.
Can I see in here? Is there lights? Like emergency lighting or something?
Emergency lighting, yes. There would be emergency lights. Good point.
Okay. This is not the location for me to get into a fight. The doc will, knowing that there's there's almost no way that there would be a zombie in here, at the same time reaching for Constance and checking to see what type of shell is loaded, right? He would be like, hello? Anyone here? QB official? We're here to help me.
I rolled like crap, but that's a stop point because that also was hilarious. We're here to help me. Okay. No response on your turn.
The doc will spend some movement, going forward. These rooms next to me, how are they, are they, shut, or, can I see into them or whatnot?
Yeah, they're all roll cages still, of the same style, but they all have, would they have labels? They would just have the same numbering system. It would all correspond with Green's files.
Right. Yeah, exactly, and it's mm-hmm. Fuck, I can't check that while, possibly, having to deal with something, so... yeah, he'll just kind of be prepared for whatever.
Be prepared for the chance of a lifetime.
So, that's your turn.
Be prepared.
Yeah.
Okay, Zach. kind of meet Vincent at the doorway. You see the boards slowly rattling, and you hear the hordes of zombies outside.
So, seeing Vincent, Zach would tell Vincent, the doc went through by the store, the end of the hallway, and they need to find their other teammates so they can meet back up with the doc, and he will continue walking down the hall.
Okay, and you hear the gunfire go off.
There. Was it like you could move? I only need to move a teeny bit, but I don't want to like double move just for that, but...
Sure. Well, double moving doesn't penalize your defense, it's quadruple moving.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Then yeah, I'll do the double move just so I can...
Yeah. Then you see the zombie up on Graves. You and Graves are like the zombie magnets of this so far.
I've noticed. Peter has noticed.
Okay. Peter, that's... Speaking of
Peter,
it's your turn.
Peter is going to do a harm spell on this and say, we should probably get to where the doc's at. Where is the harm spell? Here it is. That wasn't that good, but it's okay.
It recoils and looks back as it feels all these rats kind of like penetrating into its skin, assuming it's the same type of attack.
Yeah, probably.
I don't think you would know that it's you causing that, though. It'd just be kind of like flailing a little bit, but it's back to Graves.
All right. Were there penalties or bonuses for point blank with a
rifle? A long gun is a -2. With a pistol, +2. If I remember correctly, I will double check for you real quick. But I'm pretty sure that's correct.
Yeah.
Well, I will take one foot back then to get good range, or maybe even two steps back. I'll take one step back, and does harm count as an attack? Will he have a penalty?
It would.
Okay, so I'm going to back up, and I'm going to fire.
Okay.
Not full auto, since I'm low on ammo, just regular shot.
Okay, that is... I don't think it can actually survive its body roll, so that headshot takes it down.
Perfect. And that's move and attack. Can't move more.
Both of you... so all three of you can roll a perception check. Zach, Peter, and Graves.
Six success.
You hear whimpering and crying from this container.
Oh, shit. Okay. I don't have the movement anymore, but if I see that container, can I look at my paperclip and see what key matches up?
Yes.
Because that's what I'm doing.
Okay. Vincent, are you just still watching the door, or do you want to move or do anything else?
I would like to watch the door. I want to see the thing go boom, and then I want to throw the fire beam at the thing.
Okay. Are you making any additional noise?
No, just standing there waiting, excitedly.
Okay.
Like a kid on Christmas.
Hold on, I gotta switch GM layer. 7, 8. Don't mind this dice roll. Oh, hold on, I messed it up. I'll just have to roll from the character sheet. Uh, Doctor, you hear some banging of the doors as if something's like slamming up against it. Turn. And it is your turn.
Wait, which door?
This one here. I'll mark it. Oh, that's in GM layer. That's useless for you. This door is where you hear that metal rattling of the cage gate.
I will move to here and then look down this hallway. Do I see anything down this hallway?
Roll a perception. You do not see anything down the hallway.
Let's see here. Not seeing anything immediately down the hallway. The doc is going to start checking, because like this one's clearly making noise, right? So like the doc's gonna start checking like what is supposed to be where here on his phone.
Okay. Roll a quick investigation check. Or you can roll admin, actually. You can roll admin.
Okay. I was going to say, would I get synergy from admin?
Yeah, no, you can roll admin and then take a plus two from Green's, like, giving you everything. You just have to kind of sort through the files to see which 3B or whichever storage unit that is. Right.
And I'm not worried about adding rank bonus or anything like that. Let's see. So plus two from... Okay. And then I'm taking my time doing this. Would I get a bonus from that?
You can have another plus two.
Okay.
This seems to be a stockade of uniforms and apparel. Oh, Beck, do you have cosmic sensitivity?
Yeah. I believe I do. Let me double check.
Check because I checked everybody's but yours because you're a Vessin and nobody else.
I do have it.
Yeah, you can tell that there's something in this vicinity over here as you are like trying to think where what's
probably would have changed everything I would have done if I knew that. That's fine.
Well, I think you're focused on the zombies, and then that's now that you're hearing this, you're starting to think and focus, and you're like, no, oh, actually, yes, there is a. Some cosmic sensitivity in here too, but also here.
Wait, I need to zoom out and it's gonna, okay, can you redo, okay, where?
Basically, where the ghoul on the ceiling is.
Oh, lovely. Yep, okay. But also, do I feel the zombies outside?
Yes, you know there's a big horde of zombies outside too.
Do I feel cosmic sensitivity with zombies? I think that's the reason I've survived so long in New York.
No, actually, no. The zombies, these are plague zombies. They're not.
That's what I thought. Yeah, that's what
these
I
are
thought.
The other kind. So no, these.
But I saw you roll ghoul stealth, and I was like, I think I would sense that. Anyway, sorry.
Yeah. Good catch. So yes, you do sense that there's something that's, to quote Morthos is always saying, spooky over here. And then also in the one where the crying is coming from, you can sense there's something there too.
Ghoul cosmic sensitivity creepy or probably fine?
You can't tell that way. You just tell there's something.
Okay, it's not my turn anyway, so yeah.
Zach.
Okay.
I blooped out of the Discord without unmuting myself. No. I'm smart. So it looks like the zombies are dead, so till Peter and Graves, that the doc went through a door.
Do you need to tell us how to get through the door?
I mean, I saw how he opened it, so, and he just kind of shrugs.
It's like an emergency lever.
I would say to Zach, can I say something on Zach's turn? Are we both kind of...
Yeah, you're fine.
Okay. I would say, there's something in there. Crap. I think we need to go now. Leave it, we'll check it later. I say, nodding to the container that we heard a sound from. We gotta go get in there. And I...
Alright.
And I point to this way and I say, can we get in through here?
Yeah, there's a door on each hallway.
I say that to Zach, if he knows how to get in through, if we have to go. That's my question. Would Zach be able to get in through here?
I mean, I'm assuming I could, like, go over there and see if there's the same kind of, like...
Yeah, emergency lever that the... You have to take the turn to open it and stuff, but yeah, there is.
Okay, so yeah, then I would do that. Pull the lever.
Okay, yeah, the door opens.
Are we still in turn order?
Yeah, I think we are. Technically, yeah. So, Peter.
Yeah. I moved over here. That was a double move.
You want a quadruple move for a defense penalty?
Let me double check what my quadruple move is.
Just two
moves. No, that's four. One, two. Yeah, I kind of do. It would get me to here.
Okay, roll a quick perception.
Crud. Do I get any bonuses for,
No.
Okay. Can I just do it? Because I'm really nervous right here. I'm gonna throw in some points. That was crappy, even with the style points.
That's enough to see the open door over here.
Where?
This cage is open.
Yo!
Hold on.
Whoa, Venom's APC?
Yep, this cage is open.
Oh, beautiful. That's gorgeous. How the heck do we get that through the hallway is my next question.
There's a way.
Drive it out. when there's a way.
It goes to the garage. But yeah, did
both of my style points get on the table or just one?
I didn't say.
Okay, so it's just one.
Graves.
Alright, I would 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, because I don't want to leave anyone behind if there's someone alive. Can I, despite hearing them say, evidence somebody running, can I listen in? Can I tell if the whimpering is human or, unnatural?
Roll empathy.
Okay. Empathy, 5.
It does sound human.
It does sound human, okay. Then I would, that's my movement. Is the cage here or here?
I was imagining it in the hallway, that one, where the second one you just did.
This?
Yeah.
Okay, so I would, knock on the cage and just say, stay calm, we're here to help. I'm going to be opening this cage. Don't be alarmed. Military.
Are the zombies dead? Did you get it?
Yes, they're gone. I'm gonna open this cage and take you to safety. You're gonna be okay. Are you hurt?
One of us is, but just make sure the zombies are dead.
And I don't see anything else down the hallways.
Yeah, looks okay.
Okay. Would you want me to double move to be in the hallway to open the cage, or can I open it from here?
No, you can open it. That's fine.
So then I would get the key, and if that's my action, I would use that to open the container.
Okay. You see two survivors inside, huddled up with a third being a child. They are... hold on. I don't... Peter's not there, so I've got to do something else real quick. You know what? It'll just be... 1, 2, 3. There's three people here. And this one's a child. And they're all huddled up. They do not look threatening.
One of them said one of them's hurt. Mm-hmm. What does the wound look like? Can I get a view on it?
Roll medicine.
Four.
The kid looks injured. But it doesn't look like there's any bites or anything. It looks like he's got a fever or something.
Okay. I would see the survivors, and if I could... I don't know if I'd be able to do it without shouting, but I would try and, you know, carry my voice to Zach and, you know, say, we have survivors. Does it look safe down there?
So far, not really. I mean, it looks clear, but people are just still running down the hallway.
I think that's a dumb question for a zombie infest.
Well, relatively safe is better than nothing. It's not a dumb question. Being safe can still happen. There's levels of safety. So does it? That's why I'm shouting to Zach. Does it look safe down where he is to bring survivors?
I did inform you of the zombie horde headed our way.
Well, the zombie horde's not in your hallway, is it?
I would just yell back. There's something in the general area, but not directly in my line of sight.
Alright, so I would start ushering the civilians out to follow me.
Okay. Wait, you didn't see these tokens I put on just temporary ones? No wonder. They're just because I don't have anything else right now. So they will follow you. Vincent, are you still waiting at the door? It doesn't look like anything's breaking through at this point. Just sitting and chilling?
No, if it doesn't look like anything's making it through, I'll eat my Cheetos and walk away and see if I can find the people I showed up here with.
Okay. You want to go up or down?
I'm assuming I saw Zach go up when he left earlier.
Yeah, and he just ran past the hallway.
So I would go in that direction, I guess, because that's the last place I saw a person.
Do you want to double move or flat out run or just kind of walk?
I don't know. How far is my move?
Seven.
Seven? I'll double move since I'm assuming I made it that far and I don't see anyone yet, so...
Yeah. By the time you get here, you see Graves behind you with three survivors, and Zach is just ahead of you, kind of running after Peter.
Yeah, there's people here. I will say, say out loud, because I guess they haven't made it into the door yet. So I left the doorway. That'll be all I do.
The ghoul drops down from the ceiling onto the doctor. I need you to roll a defense, please, doctor. Does your defense bonus provide to yourself as well as it just surrounding allies?
Surrounding allies.
Okay, that's unfortunate.
And I haven't activated it this turn, so...
If it's jumping down on you, would that be more teeth or claws? I feel like it'd be claws as it tries to pull you to the ground.
I was thinking teeth. Whenever you see something jump on someone, it's usually, you know, leaping onto them to go for the neck.
That's fair too, but I think landing, dragging him to the ground with his claws is kind of more what it's trying to do. However, it does not give you any damage. Do we want to narrate how you deflect this, or as the it detaches from the tall ceiling?
I think at this point, like, the way that, like, it comes down and it, like, comes at me, like, the way that its claws, like, sink into my chest, it, like, rips some of my coat, revealing the, like, black armor underneath.
Nice.
And, like, you know, it's just like, oh, you know.
That's cool. So it kind of, it lands to the ground, throwing the fabric away, and its teeth just elongate in front of you as it roars. But that is its attack. And it's your turn.
So I imagine it's, like, right up in my shit. So, I'm gonna throw in a style point and say that the shell that's currently loaded in Constance is a, like an anti-personnel shell. Yeah, he's just gonna point blank that shit.
Okay. I will give you the plus two for point blank, because the way that you're shooting, this is basically like a pistol.
I imagine, like, this is just like a continuation of, like, the little back and forth that's already happened. Now he's just kind of like trying to, like, stick the barrel in its mouth and pull the trigger.
Yeah.
So, plus two, and then I will drop two style points into that for kicks and giggles. I got four, and then...
Okay. So, the charge doesn't even go off with it being so point blank. It, like, hits through, penetrates a little bit of the skin, and bounces it out of the backside of its neck.
The anti-personnel shells were more like the, like, hornet's nest-like concept. It's more like a real big shotgun shell.
Oh, okay, I remember those ones. I was thinking it was, like, it detonates and it's shrapnel everywhere, but it's the hornet-style ones. So it does, yeah. It does only a little bit of damage to it. But it is, your shot, so it's Zach.
Woo! I'm just gonna go 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Just gonna stand over here. Let's say close by Peter and ask Peter, like, which way do you think we should go? I don't exactly know where he went once he went through the door, so.
Then you hear the grenade piece going off the hornet's gun.
Like a real loud fucking shotgun shell. Like the loudest
probably
shotgun
that way. You've ever heard.
That would be a good bet.
Oh.
Like headcanon, the only reason why it, like, survived is because the back of its, like, throat just got blasted out. Like, its entire cheek is missing.
And it's like,
I'm gonna double move. Who needs a head?
Yeah, you see the ghoul. This is not a zombie. This is much more on all fours, almost lithe and moving very quickly, and it looks like actually from like Spider-Man Venom, or I guess he has his own movie now, but it's like has the big jaw that elongates and stuff, though part of it's now missing.
Well,
Peter.
Peter, I want to roll perception just to make sure. Do I see this, or?
Yep.
Okay, cool. Can I roll supernatural lore? What the heck do I know about things?
Yeah, and roll perception too.
That was really bad for that average.
Yeah. So you know that ghouls normally inhabit like the underground. They loiter around graveyards. They eat bodies or live flesh when they can. There's not much sense for them to be in this compound unless they got in, but assuming it was fully secured, it doesn't make sense. With a 9 perception, you also know that it's definitely not supposed to have a collar on.
I look back and I go, contact? Because this is a word I've never used to say there's a bad guy, but... Graves is, he says that whenever he sees some random person. Anyway... I say that and I go 1, 4, 5, oop, and then I use, can I use my harm spell on it? That's basically yep. One of the things I wanted to know, if a harm spell would kill it. But we'll find out.
Did you know it would be damaging to it? Yes.
I use my harm spell on it.
Okay, more of its skin shrivels and melts away as you burn it with your spell, your magic, and its attention immediately shifts over to you. Unlike the zombies, this seems to be in tune with the arcane energies that you're using and can tell that you're the one who attacked it. Graves.
I'm just going to double move and have them come with me. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, like right beside Vincent, and just say, you know, help me clear away for these survivors.
Yeah, they're a couple spaces behind you because they're not as fast, but they are following with the apparently dad carrying the kid, who's like,
is it
like
a
10?
Is it a regular action or a move action to double move? Like, do I still have my action? Can I reload?
No, if you're double moving, that takes your whole turn, and if you quadruple move, or like full on run, then you take penalties to defense.
Okay. So then that is me.
If you spend a style point, I'd say you can, but I don't know if you want to spend that.
Yeah, I don't.
Okay. Vincent. You will be muted.
So I'm just gonna, you know, keep moseying on down along the hallway, chasing after where I last saw Peter and Zach go.
Yeah, you can basically get to the next intersection. This one, at the end.
Okay. Yeah. Let me.
Not a lot of action for you, I'm afraid.
Yeah, blowing up the building we're in doesn't seem like the greatest idea, at least not yet. Ooh, can I see the ghoul from here or no?
At the end of the hallway, yes.
Do I have line of sight?
It'd be hard because it's on the ground and there's people in the way, but you also double moved, so you would not have an action for shooting.
That's fair.
The ghoul's turn. Move of 8. And it does not like what just happened to it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It drops to all fours and scurries past Zach for 6, 7, and then tries to jump onto Peter. This time it will use its teeth as it tries to sink its teeth into your face. Please roll defense.
Can I add style points to my roll?
Yes, you can use style points in two ways. You can roll them in your defense roll as normal extra dice, or if you take damage, you can delete the damage with 2 for 1s. 2 style points for -1 damage.
Do I know if ghoul attack is lethal or non-lethal?
Based off of seeing the razor sharp teeth running towards your face, it's lethal.
Okay, let's just put two in here. One, and add two to this. Eek.
Okay. Yeah, you move out of the way and maybe lift an arm, and it does bite you, but it's more like the forearm or something, not your vitals. It's
moving. Oh, did you do my health or did
I just did it for you?
Okay. I think lethal is 2, if I'm not mistaken, is what it counted for.
No, it's 1.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's 1-for-1. It's just if you take
all right, and it's 0.5.
Yeah, exactly.
Basically. Okay. Yeah.
Doctor.
Before I was attacked, what information did I gain, like, towards, like, what's in places?
This room here is full of extra, basically, apparel items. It's, like, extra gear, uniforms, if you need to look like your FBI or something, if you need flak jackets, all that kind of stuff. It's clothing kit.
Right.
It's like a closet full of wardrobes.
Disguises.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Like the master of disguise.
That's the only information that I gleaned?
For one round, that's what I was thinking. You were just looking at that one. If you wanted from before, some of the stuff that Green was texting you from what Zigzag was looking at is the warehouse has blank spots where the logs have been deleted in certain areas where they don't have a record of what's in the storage and they haven't been able to audit it to see why they were deleted or what they were.
Right.
One could intuit the room with the APC is one thing that they had deleted from the logs.
Right. Okay. I will bend an action to reload nonsense, dropping my old shell on the ground, putting in another one. And then I will move kind of along this wall more than this side because I heard noises in that, right? And not wanting to like add more problems to our problems right now. He will move 4 forward there, and like if he can be like, you know, did you guys remember to shut the door, you know, and then that will be his turn.
Okay, Zach.
Zach would respond to the doc, be like, not the last one through the door. And he'll turn to shoot the ghoul.
Okay. If you're using your pistol, it is point blank, so plus 2.
Yay!
And it is also a new round, so it does not have any defense penalties. But it probably won't need it, as with 2 hit points left, you do 6 damage. How would you like to kill it?
Just because I imagine it's facing Peter, because it just attacked Peter, so like just through the back of the skull.
Bang.
Bash your mouth, Mr. Man.
Ghoul brain just erupts from the forehead and it drops to the ground.
If it's my turn, Peter wants mental audit, cosmic phenomena in the area.
You broke.
We're out of turn order.
Yes, we are now.
Oh, what?
Becca, could you repeat that because it broke up.
Oh, I said I wanted to do a mental audit of cosmic phenomena in the area.
You want to roll supernatural lore, or just like from what you have learned previously?
I guess it would be ritual magic. I don't know if cosmic sensitivity has anything to do with magic, but if that helps with...
Are you basically trying to use your sezzant, your witcher senses?
Yes. I'm using my witcher senses.
Okay, that would be... You can use ritual magic for that to actually, focus in and try to feel out what energies are around you, and yeah.
Any bonuses for that?
Do you want to use your style point?
Nah.
You didn't even need it. So, in terms of, the supernatural, not just, a virus zombie... Which those don't really count as supernatural so much.
Yeah, they haven't shown up in my
ghouls. Those are supernatural. So are some of the things in the city. There are devils or demons. Some people have called them interchangeably amongst the hobo network. Those are mostly on the surface. You don't sense anything else in the immediate vicinity. Basically, you do sense the three Vessin, which are following Graves. So I will put their real tokens in.
Yeah, as bringing them, I probably stop at the door and go, "Oh, hey, look at this. Can I look for keys? Are there any keys on the wall?"
Yeah. So roll perception.
Perception.
Do I know anything about Vessin and
what
their general general alignment for Vessin?
They are kind of normal people with magical properties. They've got an innate cloak, essentially, an illusion making them all look human. They tend to get involved with gangs sometimes and stuff like that, but there's normal people Vessin too. That's not really any way to rule them as all in one box.
And they look normal to me, but they look like they look like animals to Peter.
Yeah.
And exactly. then my other question is, does my cosmic sensitivity sense any fun toys in
Honestly, I'm afraid. I feel kind of like that's a letdown, but no, none of the stuff that's in here is innately magical.
I have sadness. So much sadness.
I got a 5 to look for keys.
Okay, so you see there's a body right by the door, which has been... His face was ripped off. He had opened the APC door. There are keys in the body's hand.
I would grab the keys and then usher the survivors into the APC for safety, and I would tell them, as I'm getting out my supplies, I would say, let me look at the kid, let me see if the wound or anything is infected.
Okay. Do you want to...
Yeah, that's a good point. Can I check the APC first? Hold on.
He wants to know if there's drugs in it.
Well, no, I want to know, with what Desdemona said, that's actually a really good point, I completely forgot. Is there any corpses or living corpses within the backseat?
A quick glance without a roll is no. There's nobody in the APC. If you want to roll again, you can.
Perception or investigation?
Perception.
I feel like that was loaded. So loaded.
Okay. On the visor of the driver's seat is a hand... it's just a paper with a handwritten note that says, "Laugh while you can."
Okay. Interesting. I'm gonna leave the note there. Does Graves... I'm going to assume the answer is no. I'm gonna ask anyways to... possibly influence or not influence my decisions. Graves does not know who Team Venom are, right?
Nope.
Okay, so Graves puts them in the back seat and then begins taking his supplies out and asks to look at the kid's wound.
Okay. Okay, you can go ahead and make a medicine check. But the doc, you are not injured, actually. You survived that without any damage. What would you like to do?
The doc points over here at this one and goes, there was noises I was hearing in that, so be careful with that one. And then he's going to hustle through the hall to see if the door's been shut, assuming that he's been seeing people. Okay. Yeah, he's going to take the time to go shut that fucking door.
Okay. You pass, you see the APC there. The Graves looks like he's got more civilians inside of it.
Do I just inherently recognize that as a Venom's APC?
You recognize it as an APC. I probably shouldn't have titled it that, but I wanted to see reactions.
I would definitely also tell the doc, as I see him around the corner, if he's looking this direction, I would tell him, hey man, maybe you know something more? You want to check the front seat? There's an odd note. I don't know what that's about.
The doc will shut this door, and then he'll go over and check what he's talking about. I assume I see the letter.
Yeah, it's just a scrawled note, laugh while you can.
Okay, the doc is gonna look at Graves and be like, whatever you do, don't fucking start fucking this APC's engine. Let me and, Vincent, like, you know, look over this before that, just to make sure there's no fucking explosives planted on it. And then he's gonna, like, pull out his, information and note which, particular storage areas are the ones that have been erased. And then he's going to, alert everyone to those particular numbers. But he's gonna probably go out more into the hall. And be like, we need to check what's in those before we go, and double, like, you know, and then, like, you know, he'll list off, like, some of the things that's appropriate for people to know that is noted to be in locations, just in case anybody who's like, oh, yeah, I could use more ammo or, you know, whatever. And then once again, I will alert everyone that the fucking, the armory or whatever, the, like, clothes room, was making noise, and we might want to be careful about that. Maybe open that together or avoid it altogether. I don't know.
I think the doctor has learned about going
in as a group. Is that what he said? Is it cut out at the end?
Oh, in by himself is what I said, because he went in by himself and was greeted warmly.
He's got good luck doing that, to be honest. Like, the werewolf didn't get him either.
That's true.
While the doc's listing stuff off, Graves definitely says, if you find any extra medical supplies, send them my way.
Okay.
There was medical supplies, right?
Yeah, so that's a stock item. So we'll just differentiate it between stock, which Green knows that he has, and then there's the deleted files for stuff that presumably is the Rogue Spider team's gear. So if there's any gear that you want, like medical supplies, they do have that. If you wanted to go look at the other five deleted storage rooms, you can. And then
I think we should check what was in that, what's it called, first, since Graves is dealing with the Vessin.
Okay.
Which I got a 6 medicine on to check out the kid's wound.
So the kid has been bit in the arm by what looks to be a zombie.
Graves, under his breath, says, shit. And then looks up and gives what I assume to be a, you know, parent couple, a, like, knowing look of, like, what are we gonna do here?
They seem to be a little bit in shock from the whole, like, hiding here from the zombies and them being in the building and gunfire and stuff, so they don't pick up on anything if you're not verbally talking to them.
Graves, is it still the father holding the son?
I mean, if you're examining him, it's probably like sitting in the back seat with you next to him, and they're like huddled around.
So I think Graves would probably ask the dad, you know, can you just pop out and come with me for a second and lead outside the...
Yeah, that he'll come out.
Can I, before they get out, or not?
Yeah.
Never mind.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Graves would whisper, I'm sure, I mean, loud enough for everyone in the vicinity here, so Peter will probably hear Desdemona with you, and of course the dad, and he says,
whether you knew about it or not, I have some unfortunate news. Your kid is bit. It's probably not gonna last long. And then waiting to see if the doc does anything, because he's the one who gave us the antivirus.
He gave me an antivirus.
No, all of us got the...
Oh, did all... Oh, yeah, you're right. All of us did. Okay. Yeah.
Everyone got the like, pre-bite vaccination, which is different than, like, any other thing that...
There's the there's the vaccine, and then there's a antidote. They're two different things.
So, Graves would definitely probably look at the doc and, you know, whatever... Trying to calm down the dad if he's freaking out, but Graves would look at the doc and says,
if you have anything to help save the kid, I'll pay you back in kind. You know, I'm not in the game of leaving anyone behind if we can save them.
Can I, like, do, like, a supernatural lore or, like, a perception or something to tell if...
This is when I would ask the doc... Do you, know what I am?
I would know because of his file, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I figured, file. Graves just figured you were another New York hobo with your way to control this New York rats.
he thinks you've just trained them from birth.
Yeah, you're just a rat man in the rush in the tunnels.
Definitely.
He just thinks that you're the dude from, the Wanted movie.
For sure, yeah. Just assume that you're treating, like, a kid version of me. Do I know what kind of Essen they are, or if they
you
are...
You can see this guy. He's a rat dude, just like you.
Yeah, kid Doc version of me, for sure.
Perched right up at that information. I would like to blow a style point to say I have another dose on me. And, the doc will offer it up immediately. Just so happily. Like, there are, like, lights in his eyes right now. He's like, yeah, here you go.
Are you handing it to Graves?
Yeah, here you go.
Graves will take it and look at the dad and say, we might have a chance to save him, just...
For the first time, he, like, looks up at you and makes eye contact. He's like, we're doing it.
He will, walk back to the kid, say, this is gonna sting, and, give the injection. You know, tap the needle, give the injection. Okay.
DM, I would like you to look at my wisdom.
Yes, I am. I'm actually trying to remember if I had you roll specific. I remember I did. I'm just trying to remember what you rolled for it. If you don't mind, I will do a quick search in Discord. This would be for the antidote. Okay, here it is. All right. Roll your craft medicine if you could.
Like just basic roll, or do I need to add anything?
So everything that you would have had for that. So I have your research role in creating it, but now I want to run your antidote against the bite. So,
right.
If you can roll for this specific antidote for me.
Oh, How much was that again? Like, altogether, it was like 17d2.
That sounds right, but I don't know if I have everything to count it.
Yeah, that sounds right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Versus the zombie bite. Actually, it's going to beat it no matter what. The zombie bite wasn't that bad for this kid. So the antidote is injected into the Vessin kid. And, I mean, it's not going to be immediate. The kid still has a fever and stuff, but he just kind of slinks into his dad's arms, kind of like falls asleep. And for the next, like, I don't know, 30 minutes while you do anything else in here, I mean, it doesn't look like he's getting worse. It just looks like
I'm definitely also helping, you know, to cool down the fever if I have anything to help. And I just pack them in the back seat, and Graves probably shuts the door so they don't really see him. He wipes his forehead and says, "Oh, thank God I didn't have to kill a kid."
Peter's little rat heart is warmed by the fact that being up at a fight.
You are cutting out.
Cut out so bad. That was probably really good too.
Peter's little rat heart is warmed by the fact that you were helping them instead of finding drugs.
Graves would slowly walk out after. And, well, he's a doctor, okay? He's not, like, the doctor. I'm the good doctor. I may be the drug doctor, but I'm the good doctor. Graves would walk out very slowly, wiping his forehead, and says, "So if there's still a horde out there, don't you think we should check the APC first, maybe? Just in case we need to get out of here as soon as possible."
I'm more worried about where the heck that ghoul came from. Was that in your notes? Is there a way for them to get in without us knowing? That's what I'm concerned about. Is there an opening somewhere? We need to check the perimeter or something.
It was a ghoul in here? Ghouls.
Didn't you hear me say contact?
That doesn't mean ghoul.
Yeah, I think at this point you'd probably notice more that, like, my coat's been ripped and shit, and, like, my body armor's exposed.
And I legit have, like, a blood coming out of me at some point.
Oh, Jesus, you okay? Are you wounded? I'm gonna immediately pipe up, like jump up and go to help out Peter, looking over if he's wounded.
Not badly, but yes.
Alright, I'll begin taking out my supplies again and helping out Peter. So if that's a first aid, I will roll.
Yes.
And I also have Lifesaver as well, so I'm pretty sure I just feel beautiful.
It was overkill. It was literally one.
Yeah.
Kind of. Yeah, but it was painful. And
he, like, touched you and the wound, like, literally stitched itself.
Am I crazy, or did Vincent's token disappear?
Vincent's up no, here. It's,
yeah.
Oh, okay. You're up. Are you doing anything?
I was just wandering down the hallways, looking at stuff.
Yeah, there's all kinds of stuff in here. This is a requisition warehouse. So if there's anything that you want, just mention it, and I'll see if they have it.
It's in your messages already. Let's see if I can find it. It's way up.
There's a long list.
I think everything is on the list you got.
The drone thing that I sent you. Oh, that might have been on Facebook.
Oh, well, the funny thing is, there is, but it's in one of the unmarked stalls. So one of the deleted stalls does have a pack of drones in it. Of the kind that you're looking for. There's 8-pack of them.
It's just in one of these random containers somewhere?
Yeah, each room has their own. This one has their drone equipment.
You were given a list of the ones that we don't know what...
Right, and I had told everyone what the numbers are that, like, that we don't know what's in them and we need to, like, actually go through. It's kind of a part of our mission objective right now. Also, the doc is going to take some time and try and, like, look over the APC for any, like, rigged explosives or anything.
Okay. You can roll demolitions.
Is there a...
Wouldn't you mark me? Sorry.
Is there a location that has, like, food?
Yeah, there's rations, MREs, dried goods, supplies. Yeah, they've got that type of equipment, resources also.
Excellent. Yeah, I'm going to get some of that.
If you're going to the other ones, you found the APC already. Vincent finds the two big cases of drones. So those are there's eight uses of those drones. There is a group of automatic weapons that they have. So if anyone wanted heavy gear.
If anyone wants more loud things.
And then in the other cage, there's a briefcase. Not unlike one that the doc has seen before. But at the inside, if you open it, it does not have launch codes. It has a velvet interior with a skeleton key. And that seems to be the only contents of the case.
That's like an old school skeleton key.
It looks very
literally skeleton.
Yeah, it's a skeleton body for the handle, with the skull being like the bottom of the key, and then instead of like the legs and stuff, it's just the teeth of the key.
Interesting. Well, taking that, and that's not on the list of stuff that like we had.
Yeah, no, that's that was a deleted storage container.
So the deleted storage containers were heavy guns, drones, clothing, and skeleton key?
No, the clothing was not gray, greens.
Oh, okay. How many med kits could I get? How many? I currently have two.
It's basically unlimited. You can restock to full, or if you can carry more, you can.
Okay, I previously had four, so I'll just go back up to four.
Hey, while, like figuring out what's in these, like, deleted sections, the doc's gonna be, like, sending that information to, Green.
Okay. I bring back some of the food that I got. Who have been in
here. Becca, your mic's really bad. Can you...
I feed my rats! Not my rats, but the rat people.
Oh, you feed the people.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
Food
the kid,
and water.
The kid's sleeping, but the parents are eager to have it. The wife is not a rat person. It's more, she looks more feline-ish. You can tell they have a great relationship. Cat person and rat person.
I'm actually entirely nervous about this. Do you need to... Well, we're in New York and there's zombies, so...
Guys, it's Tom and Jerry.
This is the 21st century. Come on, we always have to fight stereotypes among the Vessin, not the humans, too.
I was just saying I wanted to give them some food, because I don't know how long I've been in here. And it's been pretty, backed up for a while. Yeah. Zombies.
They are happy to have the food, and you can have a style point for thinking of that. Any other gear or equipment that you'd like to basically get for free from the warehouse?
I would like to see if there are, like, special kind of arrows. I know that's vague, but I don't really know anything about that kind of stuff.
Sure. So, there's all kinds of arrows. Explosion arrows.
If you spend a style point, I'll say that there is extra arrow resources for you.
Message arrows.
Oh, I will do that.
So yes, there are. So I'll have to give you a list out of game for it. But yeah, you find a pack of some fun stuff.
Woo!
It's gonna be very Hawkeye-ish.
I want
what
to.
What about
go
the green arrow?
The green arrow.
My
Oxglove arrow.
My knowledge of superheroes is going to come extremely lacking. So if there's stuff or references or things that you want, just send them to me.
It's a TV show.
So the Doc 4 demolitions, it does not look to be booby trapped at all. You can roll a. This is not a good roll for the Doc to roll that. Let me think if there's anything that would kind of fit. It could be investigation. I was thinking empathy. How about an empathy synergy with investigation?
I'd offer to assist, but I don't know what the Doc is doing.
You can assist.
Oh, okay. So then I would assist via empathy, as I have really good empathy, so I can offer an assistance, which is what, just a bonus plus two?
Yeah. So, you can see from claw marks inside of the APC that, upon further investigation, between the note and the Doc, you knowing that, putting two and two together, this is Team Venom's APC, and then you see the scratch marks on the interior, and then, I don't know if Peter pointed it out to you, or if maybe upon further investigation... The ghoul has a collar around its neck, or it did.
I would have pointed that out.
The APC was booby trapped with a ghoul. When the virus alert went out and Green sent out, you know, abandoned ship and sent everybody to the tower, what must have happened is. They decided they were going to just take the APC because it's here. They knew it was here because they worked here. And that didn't work out for them.
Peter says if he was over here, because he came over to give people food, he would say that you have crappy friends.
I feel like Peter's charisma is really low.
Graves, I think Graves would, you know, pop to the side with the Doc and say, someone's going to have to bring them to a safe zone, and I think it's better to bring them there than bring them along with us. I will gladly volunteer for that, since I've helped them already. If it helps, I can drive, bring you to where, as close as you all need to be, head to a safe zone, and then see if I can come back. But they need to be brought to safety, and I don't think it's a good idea to bring them with us.
Well, what if we just stay here?
The Doc literally laughs. Hey, you shouldn't even be in here.
We were running.
Trust me, you don't want to be out there either. You are on limited time.
There's about a lot. Like, imagine like a litter and times it by like two of zombies out there.
Oh Jesus, sweet Lord, what are we doing? Take us to safety.
The Doc. Like mentally thinks about how like secure this part of everything is, but does not like even mention it, and just like leaves to go do like whatever he's gonna be doing in the meantime while everyone's figuring out their shit.
Would Ambrose be upset if Graves took the walk with him just to have a small conversation away from everyone?
Nah, we all know where where, you know, Ambrose is walking. He's going right to where the drugs are.
Because Graves would pop with him and, you know, whisper to Ambrose so that no one else can hear.
Listen, worst case scenario, if it's needed, as much as I would not want to do it, if it is needed, I will make sure that they don't remember this. Like a, if you catch what I'm saying, kind of deal.
The doc will be like, yeah, I get you. They haven't seen anything in here that's of importance. Those individuals, I don't know if you overheard too well, but they're not like your average citizen. They're a little bit more aware of certain things than, you know, like your average Joe.
Well, then I'm sure it wouldn't hurt Quantum Black to have a couple people under their thumb.
It does seem to please the board.
So you said there were more drugs in here?
Yeah, where do you think I'm going?
I'll lead the way. We got some work to be done.
Indeed.
So I feel like that's a pretty good shot for the two of you to be walking down the hallway to go retrieve some more goods, and we see you enter in, get your gear. We see Vincent and Peter and Zach and the family getting ready in the APC. Just to clarify, the doctor, you've got the skeleton key, right?
Oh yeah, I'm like carrying that briefcase with me.
Okay, and then
I'm also messaging Green about it and asking like if he knew anything about it before, you know, the information was deleted or whatever.
He does not. He texts back he's not sure what you're talking about. If you could send a photo of it though, he would love to see it.
Right. The doc's not gonna do that right now. He'll worry about that after like we get into the APC and stuff.
Okay. So Vincent has the drones. You're all kind of using the APC for now. Anybody taking any of the automatic and heavy weapons?
Mm-hmm.
No?
No. I don't think I would have strength for any heavier weapon than a rifle.
Okay. I might take a taser. You know.
Oh, I'm muted.
Some zombies.
Yeah, you can absolutely take a taser.
I figure what,
and
like,
is there any sort of I'm thinking about after we get into like something that would, Peter's wondering about something that would deal well with robots and machinery and then potential, you know, kidnapping zombies, forcing them to get injections afterwards and separating them. I'm wondering if there's anything in particular. And I would collect that and bring it with me.
Like
I don't have to do it now.
Like a net cannon?
Something like that, yeah.
I don't know what that's called, but sure, you can get a net cannon and I'll figure what that is.
Yeah, something.
What were you saying?
I know. Oh, like a net gun. I've definitely seen concepts of that.
Yeah, me too.
Like, you can even kind of, like, rig a harpoon gun with, like, you know, like a spear that breaks apart into a net, you know?
Okay. Any other requisitions?
I personally know that once, you know, I have some time, I'll probably have a shopping list, but...
Okay, yeah, well, just get back to me before the next game, which we'll be back in, I think it might be a couple weeks, because next week we'll be busy with something else. So I wish you all a very good night, and we will see you in the next one for episode 3.